praise the Lord. Welcome to our second month in existence right here. We're going to worship the God in a little bit here. But I'd like Brother Mike to open up with a word of prayer.
Thank you. Christmas in 2011, we're entering into a new season where the presence of God is going to be awesome. God is going to do great things in that year. There's a song that Israel and New Breed do. It's called "It's a New Season." It's a new day. A fresh anointing is coming my way. It's a season of power and prosperity. It's a new season coming to me. We're going to do this in a sea. If you know it, sing it along with us. We're going to sing "It's a New Season." It's a new
Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn. Yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable are you than the birds? Who of you by worrying can add a single hour to your life? Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Consider how the lilies grow. They do not labor or spin. But I tell you, not even Solomon and all the splendor dressed up like one of these. If this is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today, and tomorrow's thrown into the fire, how much more will he clothe you, O you of little faith? Do not set your heart on what you will eat or drink. Do not worry about it. For the pagan worlds run after such things, and your Father knows you need them. But seek his kingdom, and all these things will be given to you. Do not be afraid, little flock, for your Father has been pleased to give you the kingdom. Praise the Lord. Today we're going to talk about the new year. And what I mean by the new year, we're going to talk about worry. You know, so many of us worry. And in the Bible, Jesus says, worry. But I want to give you some actual statistics. To let you know what I'm talking about. You know that over 60% of all people who die by suicide come from a major depression. 96% of alcoholics who die by suicide continue their substance abuse up to the end of their lives. And although most gun owners report they keep a firearm in their home for their protection or self-defense, 83% of gun-related deaths in these homes are the results of suicide or someone getting shot. Firearms are used in more suicides than homicides. Death by firearms is the fastest growing method of suicide. Patients who desire to an early death during a serious or terminal illness are usually suffering from a treatable depressive condition. I'm a nurse, and I deal with this all the time. What I mean by all the time, I look at depression. Jesus says, don't worry. So I was thinking, you know, God says He'll take care of everything, but Satan has his own way. He wants to take over for you. And I was just doing some research, and you know what? Here's what it says in the secular world. What you should do if you worry. Now, it doesn't pay attention to the Bible, which says God will take over your worries. It says, shift your focus of attention away from worry. Practice thought stopping, telling yourself to stop current thought as you shift focus to other more pleasing thoughts. The mention of Jesus here. Learn physical and mental relaxations through techniques such as deep breathing, progressive muscle relaxation, imagery, or meditation. Write down your worries, and sometimes the act of worrying down allows you to let go of circular worry process. So what I'm trying to say, and also the last thing they say, is get professional help. Well, I'm here to tell you, how many of y'all worry about something? This is the new year. How many of you are worried about paying the rent? Do you worry about that, or worry about your job? Is someone going to fire you? Jesus said, don't worry. How many of us look and think of what we're going to have to wear? Oh, I can't afford the best clothes because I want to look fly. I want to look good when I go out there. We're worried about how we look. We're not worried about Jesus. You see, Jesus said plainly, do not worry. Don't worry about a thing. You know what worrying is? Remember when you were in school, and you didn't do what you were told to, you didn't study for a test, and you know, or you did study for a test, and you go to school, and you take that test, how worried is that feeling in you? That it just bogs you down. Do you know even that you can give to Jesus? How is that to never, ever have a stressful day? Because, let's face about this, if you pay your electric bill, do you worry about your electricity? You know it's paid. You don't think about, is there going to be a power surge and you're going to have the power cut off? Unless you're in New York and it's really cold. But you don't worry about if I flick on the switch. You don't say, oh man, if I go home, I wonder if the power's going to be on. I paid the bill, but I just don't know, I don't know, I don't know. No, you go. Your power bill's paid. But if you don't pay it, what happens? You worry. Is electricity going to be turned off tonight? Is it going to last the weekend? Well, Jesus says, do not worry. What's the major thing in our lives today? We're worried about so many things. So many things just take us away from what we're supposed to do. If we could just give Jesus our worry. But how do you do that? I mean, it's easy for me to say, oh, let Jesus take your worries away and He'll do everything. Well, in reality, He can. But you got to start letting go. Good example. For the first time in my life, I had an accident. Well, I've had it before. But I had a small brushing accident and I actually didn't worry. I actually said, God, I started praising God. I said, whatever's going to happen, it's in your hands, God. You do what you may. I know I'm guilty. I know that I probably caused it. And I didn't worry. I got out of the car and I walked over and I asked if they're okay. You know what God did? He took care of the problem. It turned out the other driver backed into me. And actually, we backed into each other. And he was a new driver. And so consequently, no one got a ticket. I went to Burger King the other day. Here's another thing. You know, you're almost late. You have to order some food. I had to order for work. And they worked. They had a new lady working there. And I couldn't believe it. Now, Burger King in St. Cloud is only slow anyway. I mean, I sometimes, there's a lady that comes here to the other church, and she works at Burger King. And I always ask her, is my Whopper ready? I ordered a few days ago. It should be getting ready about now. Because even go there, it's always slow. I mean, things are slow. But what I'm trying to say is, I went in there, and I ordered the food, and I knew the lady was new. You know how I knew? Because the other employees were angry with her, and they said, kidding what? And there were tickets all around. I had a number. I had number 141. And the lady next to me had 128. I knew there was a problem. And there was only six people in Burger King. And I saw the line outside. I said, I got to get to work. But you know what? I actually, for the first time in my life, this happened last week, I did not worry. I said, that's God's job. And believe it or not, it only took 12 minutes. That 12 minutes could have been the longest 12 minutes. And I started laughing at myself, saying, you know, I usually worry and I fret and I get upset, and everything worked out fine. I let God do the worrying for me. I'm tired of having ulcers and getting stressed out. You know, when you have a problem, give it to God and say, God, I'm giving you my problem. My rent is due. I don't know if I have enough in that paycheck to cover it. I'm giving it to you. I'm just going to go to work. I'm going to continue to praise God. And I know when it's due, you'll be taken care of somehow. If it isn't, there's a reason, but I'm not going to worry. Do you realize you can actually probably sleep the whole time until rent's due? You might get a little nervous on that day, which you shouldn't be. But what I'm saying is, give your problems to God. Physically give them. Go be alone and put all, in fact, like they said, write down your problem. Write down all your problems that you have, all the stresses, boyfriends, husbands, money, even the threat of going to court. Write it down and say, God, this is your problem. Fold the paper, put it in the Bible, and say, God, that's your problem. You're going to fix that. I'm just going to worry about praising you. I'm going to worry about talking about how great you are. What's in there? You told me, God told you that He'll take care of it. And my message, even though it's short today, is don't worry. You look at the passage here. I love electronic stuff here. This Bible here that I'm going to look at, so I push the right button. It says very plainly, I just love what God says. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life. There can be no clearer statement than that. Don't worry about what you eat. Don't worry about your body. Don't worry about what you wear. Life is more than food. The body more than clothes. Now if you look at that, if you dissect it, I said, do not worry about your life. That's anything that goes wrong in your life. Anything. Love, money, anything. Anything you eat. How many times, I don't know about you, but have you ever had been in a situation when Brother Micah told me, I gotta share this story. He had a 19 cent gas bill. I love this story. He was really short of money, he woke up late, and he only could find 19 cents in his house. And he went to the gas station and asked for 19 cents on pump number, let's say 2. 1 dime, 1 nickel, and 4 pennies. Now what I'm saying is, you knew he was worried. But you could take that worry and say, God, I tell you what, I'm just going to give my problem to you, and I'll take my 19 cents of gas, because no one gave me any more money, and he was still there. Well, how many miles did you drive in that 19 cents? 20 miles and 19 cents of gas, and it wasn't a brand new car. That's fueled by God. You got to give the problem to God. Now, I don't recommend you go and say, okay, when I leave here, I'm going to give 19 cents to the pump to save money on gas, and I'll make it. I don't recommend that, because I don't think you're going to make it home on 19 cents. But the thing is, you'll make it by giving Him your problems. Don't worry. This church here is going to go, we're going to go through a change. What's happening, the senior pastor tonight is his last service. And we're going to be asking to have this fellowship hall to ourselves. And we're going to grow and get bigger. But the question is, do I worry? Yes, I worry. And all of a sudden, I was talking to myself, and God spoke to me and said, listen, the pastor that you have coming in is supposed to be really, not conservative, but contemporary, like what we like to do. And I'm thinking, why am I worrying? God's in charge. This is His church. This is not mine. I'm just a person that works for God. That's His business to find the building. It's like when you work at work. It's their business to find where your paycheck comes from. You don't sit down and say, okay, we need the money. Let me see the ledger sheets. Let me see the accounting thing. I want my paycheck. I'm going to let God worry about it. And I actually feel a lot better now. And there's some people that are stressed out right now. But I'm not worried because God said, do not worry. You know, don't worry. And we were talking about having this church grow. There's another one with me. Don't worry. We're all worried. I want this church to grow. I want to spread the gospel to everybody. Well, yesterday we went out and we fed over 90 people that were homeless in a restaurant that's always packed. And I talked to the owner and I said, I'm not asking for financial support. Hint, hint, hint. He didn't take that hint. So what I said was, can we put a flyer about our church every week, like a newsletter. We'll start putting out newsletters. Can we put it in your restaurant? And it's always packed. I can put it on the outside. And he goes, no, you're going to put it inside. So now, a restaurant that's always packed. That coffee cup, you ever seen that place? It's always packed. They're going to have our newsletter inside their church, inside their restaurant, be there every week. And it doesn't cost us a dime. God said, don't worry. What's a better way to let everybody know about our church in a place like that? Because I didn't have to worry. God's in charge. He's on duty. It's not me. I just really feel that we're going to, as this year comes to, we're worrying about gas prices going up to $4 a gallon. You know, you've heard of that, haven't you? It's going to go up. How many of us are worried? You know, are we going to be able to make it to work? They kind of worry about that. Truly, just drive by the gas pump and go up to the cashier and say, you know, I'm not worried, God's in control. I don't think they'll give you the free gas, but what I'm saying is, as you drive by there, realize God is the one that said, don't worry. God's the one. I'd like to close with that. And I'd like to just remember all the animals. They're fed. It's amazing. Look how cold it is out there. We have chickens. They don't even freeze. Imagine if we stood there all night. I think we'd freeze to death. My chickens are hanging in there because God's taking care of them. They don't. You ever seen an animal? How many of you have dogs or any animals? Do you ever see a dog or a cat worry about? They want to eat now, but they never sit there and ponder where the food's coming from and worry about it all day. They lay around until you feed them. Maybe we should just praise God all day and lay around until He gives us something He wants to, because He will. That's what I'm saying. Let's be more like the cat, just laying on the bed, chilling out, saying, I know I'm going to get my food, I'm not worried. God will pet me a little bit. As long as I purr when He comes in the house, that's faith. Worship God. He'll take care of us. But right now, do you have that song ready? Okay, we're going to do the offering. It's like we have a special thing we didn't practice it. I didn't practice it. Caleb is going to, he wrote a song. And is your microphone working?
Yes.
Perfect.
Clearly.
Not like last time.
Yes.
Okay, there it is.
This one.
Do you need someone to play drums while you do it, or how you want to do it?
I play drums for you, sir.
Okay, praise the Lord. I have no idea how this is going to turn out, except I know it's going to turn out great.
Go ahead and go down to you. Father God, we thank you for this time that you have given us, Lord. Thank you for the service thus far. Lord, as we get ready to take up our offering, Lord, we've actually invested for the client, for those who gave, bless them, and those who didn't give, bless them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. I wrote this song in like 5 minutes. I ain't lying. I can't lie to church. It's like a little rap song that came to me. I don't know if y'all can follow me, but okay, here we go. It's called Life. We're not going to hear a door. Every time you turn around and see something not to do, you should hear God to pray, because it's better than you. Every time you turn around and see something not to do, you should hear God to pray, because it's better than you. There's a lot of stuff going on in the world. You see God, Peter, Ron, the man, and baby girl. Sometimes I'm living there, but it's getting better. Trying to make a change, no matter what happens. I'm down for the better, in my own groove. We need a help, man, just to make it through. No more thinking about it, no more making our move. No more feeling left out, but no more change about you. I wanna see it proper, I wanna see it change. I'm trying to take a moment to cry because of what we do. Don't be clever, you may not see it, but it goes through too. Every time we turn around, see something out of the news. You should hear God pray, because it could have been you. I'm gonna get hurt. Every time I turn around and see something on TV, I gotta get God to pray, because it could have been me. Let me get personal. I know I've done some things that I ain't proud of, but everyone can say, I thought you just pain, because it's good. All that one and three took me enough to go. That's the end of this, all of our days. We can do it, Jesus. He can make it about this. Now we love him. Now you love the kids. So take it to God and let it come in. Every time you turn around and see something doesn't do, you should give God the praise, because it could have been you. Tell your neighbor, say, every time you turn around and see something doesn't do, you should give God the praise, because it could have been you. Now listen, just remember, anytime you watch Can't Not Do, whatever maybe your new shit is, don't think about that in the back of Avenue. Shit you never do. A flood that hit your house. You couldn't get hit by a car. Just feel that God loves you, He cares about you. Every time they turn around and see something hard to do, you should give God the praise, because it could have been you. Every time they turn around, see something on TV, I gotta give God the praise, because it could have been you.
You see, I learned something long ago. All music is from God. Why should you just be set on one style of music? You can praise any way you want. Now, I really want you to praise. As we get ready to close, I want you to praise like you did the other day there. Brother D. Smooth.
Oh, let's go.
Praise the Lord. We need to as we leave here today, we need to leave on a happy note. Because when you go off clubbing, do you walk out sad? If you met somebody or you had a good time, you walk out with a smile.
Happy.
You know, we're leaving God's house. We need to leave this house with a smile. Like, I'm going to go to Brother Tito's house and show him my motorcycle, and I'm going to be glad he sees it, and I'll see his. And even though it's going to be cold, because that's what the weather says, I know I'm going to leave happy. So when we leave church today, we're going to play some music, and we're going to praise God with a happy smile, truly glad that we're here.
Everybody needs to stand on their feet with the Lord. This is Angel and Happy Music. This is not a live here. We're going to have a good time today. Yay! Yes, mic check. Okay. All right. I need to be like this. Boot, tat, boot, tat, boot, tat. Oh! Can we speed it up a little bit? Come on! Let me hear. for the Lord. Everything I do it for the Lord, for the honor of Him. All right. We got one more, and Brother Mike is going to lead us out and finish it with something smooth. Yes. Yes, I'm the funny one in the group, as you can see. It doesn't matter. You know what? Since God has blessed us with to play any style of music, from the congregation, can you tell us what type of style of music you like and we will play it for you?
Orange juice.
Orange juice. Tutti Frutti or... Grapefruit? Yeah, grapefruit.
What do you want to hear? What do you like? Like jazz, blues? Who? Blues what to the you? Challenge. Yes. Blues to the challenge.
I bet $5
that they're going to do. Well, not that far. Anyone have a particular style?
Can I get blues?
Okay, let's do a blues thing.
Blues.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to do it in the key of A. Okay. Brother Michael, lead us.
Celebrate.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's see.
together. Everybody stand to your feet, grab hands with your neighbor.
Manos, 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 please step past here. Please step
past here. Okay. Father God, we thank you for this time. We thank you so much for this great afternoon. We thank you for the great fun that we can have just in your presence. God, we thank you for being so faithful to us. Throughout 2010, you proved yourself over and over and over again. God, we just pray that you would continue to be faithful in 2011. God, let us see better things than we've ever seen. Let us do more than we've ever done. God, let us go higher than we've ever gone. We pray against the enemy right now that would come against our families, that would come against our homes. God, that would come against just everything that you call for us to be in our lives. But God, we thank you right now for your faithfulness, for your love, for the power and the might of your Spirit. God, as we leave this place, give us strength and protection from your angels. And we'll come back in a new year, giving you all the glory and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Consider yourselves dismissed until 2011. I'll see you next year.
I'd like to say one thing real quick. We will be here next. Step right here, it'll be easier. Next Sunday, we'll be meeting here. I want to personally say thank you to my wife, Marisol, for sticking with me, my mom, and of course, Brother Tito, Tina, and his family. But I'd like to say, Brother Caleb has stepped up, and he's going to be our youth minister. He's going to be in training. He's going to turn 18 in February, and then he's going to actually become an actual youth minister. We have to wait until he turns 18, but he'll be in training. So as we grow, we got somebody that's already in the high schools to start bringing them here. It's really important. We need to step out and do everything we can for God. Again, I want to say thank you very much, and we'll see you here again next Sunday. But as the beginning of the new year, we're going to have a newsletter. We're going to start having some home studies to practice, to worship God, and some Bible studies. We're going to be starting that this new year. Now that we've got established a little bit, we're going to start having Bible studies. So we keep on going up, growing. Coming to church for a service is not just enough. We've got to grow inside to God and with God. Praise be to God. Thank you.